That's Santa Barbara Island.
Is it the little one out there? I forgot what it's called.
Yeah. It's only like a square mile. No way. Oh, I'm out of breath already. Let me take your
reins. That section of Mulholland is one of my favorite. And lead you to the promised land. Yes, I'll take you to the faraway land.
Cause that's the place where I want to be. That's the place where I want to be. Look at that. What a shot. You taking a piss with the ocean. I can't believe this guy has his own pond. Who can afford that? Like, that's not a natural spring up here. Like, they actually have to fill that up with tap water. Yes, I wanna do. Wanna be. That's Santa Barbara.
There's a little one out there.
It's only like a square mile. No way.
Oh my gosh, I have to download something.
It sucks.
Oh my gosh. Well, it was fully charged like a few weeks ago, the last time I used it. Unbelievable, this isn't happening. Oh, I gotta tell you what happened. I was over at the top of Reseda, and you know, we're allowed to go to 400 feet. So I took the thing almost to 400 feet, and then I see a plane, Cessna, coming right at me. And I'm like, oh shit. And I start bringing it down.
Yeah.
And then I realize, oh my gosh, that Cessna's like at 300 feet. Like, and then I start going back up. I'm like, up, up, up. And literally, like, the thing eclipsed my drone. Wow. Like 100%, you know?
Whoa. It doesn't look like we're stepping out of the way. It actually looks like it's just
spinning. Well, I didn't see it coming.
Something's odd.
One of the coolest roads on the planet.
Something is definitely odd.
For sure.
Oh, somebody's just like, you know, taking the shortcut to the winery. That's what that is.
Vineyards below it. I've shot there before, and when we were working on the Mentalist, we were shooting there 1 year.
Dude, that thing is crazy. Is it really okay that individuals have enough money to do shit like that?
Yeah, you know.
Is it a good thing?
I'm not into the whole communism thing, so.
It happens when it rains all the
time. I know.
Right, like, they literally took what they used to plow snow down this road. Yeah. Or else it would be covered in rocks.
Yeah. That's super
simple. But, you know, these point and shoots, like, they don't really give professional results. Like,
no, but, you know, but for stuff that you're going to be throwing on the web, it's perfect. It's fine. You know, I mean, it's not going to play on a you know, giant screen, so who cares, right?
Right.
You know, that's where you're going to really see the difference, that it's not a professional,
Like that rainbow camera. Will definitely, like there's a rainbow right there that you pointed out that will not show up on this video right now.
I'll bet it shows up more.
I'm going to check later.
I'll bet it shows up more when you actually look at it.
Do you know where I can get a mini dead cat for the mic on this thing?
Go to, check out locationsound.com.
Location Sound.
Yeah.
Are you a member for GoPro?
No.
They have a $5 membership now where it's cloud. And I'm thinking I'm going to do it because, like, if I get into a thing with a passenger when I'm Ubering, like, I could point my GoPro at them, and then eventually it's going to load into the cloud through my phone. But anyways, I better get going. I'm late.
Okay.
I think the Oscars already started.
Yeah. I didn't watch the Oscars.
You watched the Golden Globes, right?
Yeah, I couldn't care less.
Why not?
I had a bunch of fun. I mean,
I am running so late. I did tell my mom that I would come have dinner and watch the Oscars, so. But, I mean, you know, it just started. I will get there. Alright, so. This is Oscar dinner. Right here. Oh, there's my dad. I wasn't sure if I was going to make it on time to pick it up, so he came to pick it up, but this is Senor Sol right here. Here, let me zoom in there. There we go. This is the car wash that I go to, like every other day. Up dinner. Without my camera.
Oh no.
Like I left it sitting, I set it by the salsa bar and then I left it sitting there. You gonna be able to hold that?
Yeah.
If you're ever in Northridge, definitely check out Senor Sol. But if you're ever in Reseda, go to Melody's. Much better.
Tacos.
You want the chicken, huh?
We asked for 4 veggie tacos.
There. 2 more veggie tacos.
Separate.
Here's. Hard chicken. Whoa, this is heavy.
Yeah.
It looks like they gave us 3.
Cool.
Excited? I'm excited.
funny.
This is the best part right here. Oh no, they put the foil on top. Oh, it's coming off. Good.
They always have done that.
Look, if you take it off right away, it doesn't stick. That's good. What is that?
Steak piccata. That would be something for you to get, huh? And this.
I had to get a picture of your steak piccata.
This is a chicken tostada. It's really salad. Mm-hmm.
So I can do this too.
I can turn around. Oh, that's really cool.
Chips, that's it?
Chips. Well, I have tacos too.
We are also immigrants. I'm from Kenya.
And I'm from Kenya is in the house. And I am from Pakistan and Iowa. Two places that nobody in Hollywood can find on a map.
Gosh, I haven't had this in
and
so long.
And like everyone in this room and everyone watching at home, we are dreamers. We grew up dreaming of one day working in the movies. Dreams are the foundation of Hollywood, and dreams are the foundation of America.
And so... to all the dreamers out there, we stand with you.
So, anyways... I enjoyed the Oscars. I thought they were cool. I thought it was cool that Frances McDormand won. Her speech was great. That was so funny when Jodie Foster was like, street! I missed the beginning. Oh, the jet ski thing, that was funny. In the beginning, apparently, they said that they were going to give a jet ski to whoever had the shortest thank you speech. And Helen Mirren was presenting the jet ski when they showed it as if it was like the Price is Right. You know, she was like a Price is Right model, like modeling the jet ski. So good. Anyways. So, yeah, the Oscars were cool. It's time for me to press some clothes. Oh, that could be a good video. I'll show you like the proper way to press your clothes. Well, I mean, really, there's more than one way to skin a cat, but there, you know, my friend, Sam Duran, you could look him up. He taught me how to press, and he presses like he's better than a professional. Like, he's so good at pressing clothes. He taught me everything I know. But anyways, I gotta get to this before I can get to bed. So, yeah. Later, slave drivers. Peace.